A beautiful aerial look of downtown Minneapolis and Target Field. It's Interlake Baseball on the show. Now from the home of the 2014 All-Star Game, a look at Target Field in Minneapolis. Today, in high definition, it's an exhibition matchup between the Milwaukee Brewers and the Minnesota Twins. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Matt Vasgersian here with you. I'll be joined in just a minute by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, but first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Milwaukee Brewers, as Ron Renneke has his guys lined up like this. They'll face a tough matchup indeed as they go to work against veteran right-hander Ricky Nolasco. Defensively, the Twins will align themselves like this. Gene Segura will take his first cuts of the ball game here. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Should be a picture perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. Florimond will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone.
Maybe a pitch here that he's trying to do a little too much with. He just can't get on top of it. Winds up an easy pop out.
Chris Davis steps in now. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Nothing wrong with a pop out and a strikeout when you're out on the mound. And he's saying, I'll take this all game long.
Ryan Braun will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Gone in order are the Brewers. And now the Twins will go to work on offense. We've got no score. Starting lineup for the Twins looks like this. They'll match up against an ace and a workhorse all wrapped into one, the all-star right-hander Yovani Gallardo. And there you see a look at the defensive alignment behind him for the Brewers. Alex Presley will get his first shot at it here. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
Well, that may have been the last pitch in the at-bat that he could do something with. He's not going to get anything better than that.
Here's a swing and a shot back up the middle. In there, a base hit.
Well, that curveball is going to be an important pitch for him to locate going forward. This one's not terrible, but it is over the plate. It gets turned into a leadoff single.
Brian Dozier will stand in now. He'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. To fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. And a fastball here is swung on and lifted in the air to left. Davis will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Joe Mauer will get his first opportunity now. Runner still at first with one away. Runners on first with one down. Here comes the 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Just overmatched him there.
Now a swing and a ground ball to third. There's one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. An inning in the books. No score on the show. Aramis Ramirez leads things off now in the top half of the second. On the way. Now a bullet back up the middle, and that'll be a base hit, the first one of the game for the Brewers.
Well, you get a good hitter in a fastball count, he'll know what to do with it. Heck, he's probably a 500 hitter when he gets a 3-1 fastball in the zone. That's almost too easy.
Carlos Gomez will dig in here.
Come on, Glenn.
1-2.
The count is 1-2.
He waits. Now the pitch. And he swings on top and sends it on the ground out to second. And he'll get the fielder's choice play at second, but that's all.
Well, you could have put the first base bag out in the outfield grass on this play. You're not going to double this guy up. He's too fast. Still, a pretty good job of at least getting that lead runner at second base.
Jonathan Lucroy will stand in. No score here as we play inning number two. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Batting seven, first baseman, Juan Francisco
will stand in here for the first time, looking to pick up that runner from second with two away here. And he gives this a pretty good ride that time, but that's going to be up amongst the crowd, a foul ball. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Hit hard on the ground to short, And this gets right through him, and that may be a run. And on the error, a run is going to score.
Yeah, this ball might have caught him in between hops. I mean, he might have been unsure which way to turn his glove, over or under the ball. Instead, just goes right through him.
Caleb Gindel will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. One on the way. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
And you can see it. He's upset with himself out there at short. And he should be. He's a big leaguer. He'd like to get a ground ball here to get himself off the hook.
And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory. And that'll slice just foul at the last moment. The 2-2. Rolled foul off to the left, so he stays alive. Swinging a ground ball towards the middle, and that'll get through into center field for a base hit. Throw will hold that runner at second base, and now there are two on with two out.
A good job there of making a two-strike adjustment. Very compact there. He uses the middle of the field, and this just finds its way into center for a base hit.
Scooter Jeanette will get a shot now with two on and two out here in inning number two. Swing and a ball hit back up the box. Throw on to Maurer will be in time, and that retires the side. Brewers forced to settle for one. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Brewers one and the Twins nothing. Josh Willingham will start things off in the bottom of the second. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
Trying to change the eye level there. After the fastball up, they come right back with an off-speed pitch to the knees. But he stays right on it, drives it for a base hit.
Oswaldo Arcia will be the batter. Stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2.
Let's go, Twin.
Swing and a ball headed towards the hole, and that'll get on through into right field for a base hit.
Let's train our show motion camera on that runner at first base. Here, he might have had a shot to get around to third, but you see him have to hold up to make sure the baseball doesn't hit him. And by the time he gets going again, he knows he'll have to hold on at second base.
And that misses 2-2. Where do you go from here?
I think he's set up for something off speed. If you can put that changeup below his knees, you won't come within a foot of it.
And And this is low, but it's corralled quickly, and both runners will have to hang on.
Well, this curveball, it just disappears. He thinks he's right on it at the plate. Look where it winds up, completely out of the zone. And that's what you want as a pitcher. You want hitters to chase pitches that aren't strikes.
Trevor Plouffe digs in at the plate. Here's a ball swung on and lofted in the air out toward right center. Braun is over to his right as he puts this one away, two down. So it's first and second with two men gone, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Kurt Suzuki. Here's the 2-2 home. Now a swing and a ground ball, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Twins strand a pair. It remains 1-0. Gene Segura will get a second crack at it here. He flied out to lead off the ball game. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
And that's not, that is not good.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy out, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound out there. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Chris Davis will get another shot. Called out on strikes his first time around. Fight. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. On the ground to second. In time to first, and there are two away. Ryan Braun will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And this will find the seats behind the first base dugout. On good opposite field power here as this fastball is taken high and deep to right. And that is into the right field seats. It's a home run. Ryan Braun with the solo home run. And the Brewers move out in front now 2-0.
Well, even though they were able to face this guy in the absolute best position possible, which is two outs and the base is empty, that still doesn't mean he can't make you pay. And he unloads here for a long home run, though it is a long solo home run.
Aramis Ramirez will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. And that is into right field, a base hit.
A pretty good swing there. You'll watch. Head stays down, ball gets deep in the zone, and he lets those hands lead the way, and he drives it to right field. That's as good an approach as you're going to see.
Carlos Gomez will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time.
Ball
Here's the full count offering. And this one's hit on the ground, but foul. Hit hard to the right, but foul. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still full at 3-2. He'll try it again, 3-2. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Now there are two ways you can go here as a pitching coach. So he's got to make a judgment call out there. He knows what buttons to press with each of his pitchers. You know, some guys you've got to reassure and be very positive with. You know, other guys, they respond better when you go out and challenge them. Really got to read them the riot act.
Jonathan Lucroy will stand in with two on and two out here in the third.
Let's go, Quinn.
Now the 1-1. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. To two balls and two strikes now.
And that curveball still hasn't shown up yet. It's normally a real good pitch for him, but it hasn't served him well at all so far.
Let's go, shut him down.
No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there. A lot of deep counts for these guys early on.
And the more the better as far as they're concerned. They'd like to get him out of here as quick as they can.
Oh, he took a big swing that time as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Big strikeout there, and they'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. Brewers do pick up a run on the Ryan Braun homer. We play 2.5. It's 2-0 Milwaukee. Pedro Florimon makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. Full count offering on its way. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
And now on the mound after the leadoff walk, you put yourself in a situation where you're going to give these guys a good chance to get that run right back. I mean, here's where he'll need to try to get the next guy to hit something on the ground.
Alex Presley will stand in now following leadoff walk, and might we see a bunt attempt here in a two-run ball game?
Every extra run helps. It's a possibility, but I think they'll probably let him take his chance of swinging away.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Wow, no chance of getting on top of that fastball. I mean, that's helmet level right there.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Nobody out, runner on first. Swing and a hot shot towards the hole. And that's by him into right field for a base hit. Brian Dozier will stand in, and his guys have got something cooking now with two on and nobody out.
And down by two, this is a good opportunity to try to put yourselves level.
Let's And this is fouled back and out of play. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Braun moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. But he's safe at third as he's able to scramble back.
Good job there at second base of doing the math in his head and figuring out he can make it up to third. So that puts runners on the corners now with only one away.
Joe Mauer will be the batter, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in a strike zone.
Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Swing and a tapper out in front. The second for one. Return throw is in time. How about that? They do turn two, and it gets him out of the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. More baseball on the show right after this. Juan Francisco will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. Pretty well hit. Deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats. Foul. Now a swing and a foul tip, but it's held onto by Suzuki. A nice job there as they record the strikeout.
This is one of those guys that you can spend all your time in the video room watching what his pitches look like, but until you get out there and see it firsthand, just have no idea how much his stuff moves around.
Caleb Gindel will dig in. He singled his first time around. Hits are now even at four apiece. And he's right on the fastball there as this is hit pretty well out towards deep left. There to handle it is Willingham. Two gone now.
And you'll see where this pitch is. It's up. But it's up far enough that he can't quite get on top of it. And he winds up lifting a lazy fly ball.
Scooter Jeanette will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Line hard. That's slicing just foul. Swing and a miss on the breaking ball, and he sets him down for out number three. Three up, three down for Milwaukee as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Josh Willingham will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. One-one. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Ramirez with it at third. Throw by Ramirez is in time for the first out.
Up next for Minnesota,
Oswaldo Arcia will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
And I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. And he's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Jason Kubel will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. No runs, four hits, and one error make up the totals for the Twins to this point. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Well, that's an opportunity wasted on the mound there. Now, a hitter's got to be defensive on 2-2, but that was so far outside, he didn't even have to worry about chasing it.
And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, two-way, you're just looking to get on base somehow, especially when this guy hasn't given you anything so far. So at the very least, make him work out of the stretch and throw a few more pitches here.
Trevor Plouffe will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk. Now a swing, and he popped him up. And no ordinary pop-up at that. This is way up there. And over near the on-deck circle, he puts this away, and the inning is over. Twins wind up stranding one. They trail it here 2-0. Gene Segura will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. Gets under the fastball there and pops this one up. This is just beyond the infield on the right side. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth.
This has been the story all afternoon. They have just not been able to get on top of his fastball. Here's another pop-up to prove it.
Chris Davis will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Now some action out in the Minnesota pen, as it looks like both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. And an early birthday gift as he swings and misses at ball four.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing it.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Yeah, they went to the slider there on 3-2, and that's a pitch where you're really hoping a hitter will see fastball and swing through it. But it didn't work out that time. He winds up losing him.
Ryan Braun will dig in, 1-for-2 to this point in the ball game.
He's gonna go!
Two runs, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. The 3-2 pitch. And there's ball four as this one gets away a bit.
That's an easy take right there on the 3-2 pitch. Not all that inviting at all. You want to at least make the guy think about hacking up there. Instead, now he's on with one away.
So two men are on with one man out. And here's the powerful Aramis Ramirez. Grounded, foul. Full count, three balls and two strikes. EK, where are you going now on 3-2?
I still got to work a corner. Not just going to throw it right down the middle and grab a strike. Can't be a giveaway pitch. A
couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away.
Turn two.
And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
These guys really haven't had all that many great chances offensively. So, you know, they'd hate to see this threat go by the boards. Not a good time for a strikeout at all.
Carlos Gomez. See what he can do here with two on and two out here in inning number five. Two down, runners at first and second. Gomez waits. Here's the 1-1. Outside, 2-1.
You know what? He's starting to skate on some thin ice here, and sooner or later, he's going to have to challenge him.
Now a slider is swung on and grounded toward short, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. A couple of walks, but no damage. Don't touch that dial, or the remote for that matter. More on the show right after this. Kurt Suzuki will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they've pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two.
And you know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. And that's a good job of recognizing off speed and then holding back on the swing.
Here we go.
Fastball is looked at for strike two.
Yeah, he must have been looking for that same breaking ball because that pitch, it's right there.
And there's a fastball that's hammered the other way to deep right field. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double. Pedro Florimond will dig in. Drew a walk his first time around. That one's in there, 3-1. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Swing and he pulls the fastball that time high in the air toward fairly deep right center. Gomez is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning.
He might have been playing things a little cautious there at second base. That ball looked deep enough to me that he should have been thinking about advancing on it.
Alex Presley will stand in. Two hits in two trips thus far. Out in front of the fastball here as he lifts a fly ball out toward right field. Braun will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
The batter, second baseman, Ryan Dozier.
Ryan Dozier will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far. Two out here and a runner at second. Keeping him close there at second. Now the pitch. He ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2.
And now what do you go with here on the 1-2 count? I got a feeling that this one won't be in the strike zone either.
Fouled back. And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. One left for Minnesota. They're still down. It's 2-0. Jonathan Lucroy will get things started here in the top of inning number six. Now some action out in the Minnesota pen, as it looks like both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. A little bit outside, 2-1. And now a pitch on the way. And this is hit sharply on the ground toward the hole. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Focus now.
First baseman number 21, Juan Francisco.
Out of the Minnesota dugout now is skipper Ron Gardenhire. And that's going to do it now for Ricky Nolasco. He'll wind up lasting just five innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Caleb Thielbar will get the assignment on the mound here, as he'll enter with a runner at first and nobody out. Juan Francisco will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher, as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. Swing and a ball lifted into straightaway center. There to take it is Presley, and there's one away. Caleb Gindel will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. The 1-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Here's a look over to first and a dive, but he's back in there. Here's another 1-2. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away.
Look at it, guys. Double him up right here.
Now here's a swing and a little bouncer out to the left of the mound. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out.
Yeah, and the only silver lining to this offensively is that you get that guy up to second base, and now he's in scoring position with two outs. But I would doubt seriously that that was his intention.
Scooter Jeanette will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Boy, what a nice job so far of working himself into a hitter's count. Now he can go to work on maybe picking up that two-out RBI out of the nine hole.
Come on, hold it down.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
And he's always so tough on left-handed hitters. That slider is just so difficult to pick up.
Here's the 2-2 offering. Just does stay alive as this is fouled back. Out out in front of the fastball, but this is skied into straightaway right. Arcia is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Milwaukee leaves one, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Back with Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, as Joe Mauer settles in to start things out for Minnesota. Two and one to the left-handed hitting Mauer. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. And he's retired, one away.
Well, only three strikeouts for him in the ballgame, but when you've got that slow stuff, keeping guys off balance, you don't need to rely on strikeouts.
Josh Willingham will dig in here. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out.
Here we go.
Here's a bouncing ball now headed for the shortstop, Segura. Throw on to first, two gone.
And we get a look there at his pitches by inning. He's at 81 now after that last pitch, so he should be good for a little while longer.
Oswaldo Arcia come in now with two away, and to this point at least, so much for having the 3-4-5 guys get the rally started.
Yeah, it's been an important inning for that man out there on the mound. He's held his ground, and he may get through the teeth of this lineup, still holding on to that lead.
Payoff pitch coming. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. So a great half inning of work by Giovanni Gallardo. His guys lead it 2-0. Welcome back to Target Field here in Minneapolis. We're on to the seventh now with the Brewers out on top. If you're joining us late, good time to get caught up as there's our game summary to this point. Gene Segura will lead it off here in the top of inning number seven. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. The payoff pitch one more time. And this is on the ground toward the hole. Look at this! And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out.
Well, that's highway robbery right there. Boy, if he doesn't knock this thing down, I don't think there's any chance the second baseman was going to be there in the hole. And not only does he make a great play, but he also hits his pitcher right in stride, which is not always as easy as it looks.
Chris Davis will dig in now, hitless in his two at-bats so far. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Since coming in the sixth, I mean, he's knocked down five in a row. It's giving him a real lift out there.
Ryan Braun will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Gone in order are the Brewers. They're up 2-0. Jason Kubel will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Oh. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting into foul territory now toward the third base dugout. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Another 0-2 coming. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Now a fastball driven the other way out to deep left field. A leap at the wall, but forget it, it's gone. A home run. A solo home run for Jason Kubel. And the Twins cut the lead in half here. It's now a 2-1 ball game.
Oh, and you know what? I think he's going to kick himself out there in left field when he watches the tape replay and realizes just how close he came to robbing this home run. I don't think he quite got the timing down right, because if he had, I think he makes this play. Instead, this is going to sneak over the wall for a home run.
Trevor Plouffe will dig in. 0-for-2. He's flied out and popped out so far. One pitch on the way. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, got in his kitchen big time right there.
To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
Full count pitch on its way. And he takes strike 3 called on the fastball. 1 gone.
Oh, he's definitely had his way with the bottom of the lineup so far. They've got only 1 hit against him combined, and he sets another man down on strikes right here.
1 gone now in the Minnesota 7th, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Kurt Suzuki. The 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. And now one taken by Suzuki as he draws it even at 2-2.
He showed him that slider running away 2 times in a row. Now might be a good time to call him that two-seamer running in.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Here's another 2-2. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And there's your tying run at second base with a 1-out double.
And you know, they were not catching up to that fastball early on, but they're catching up to it now. You can see he's all over this one and just waffles this thing. Rips it all the way to the wall, and he's in the second with 2 bases.
Now here comes Brewers manager Ron Renicki out of the Milwaukee dugout, and that'll be the last we see of Giovanni Gallardo. So a good job all in all this afternoon, and as it stands, he can only win this one as he departs with a 1-run lead. Alfredo Figueroa will get the call now as he'll try to get the final 2 outs and send this one along into the 8th. Pedro Florimond will be his first assignment out of the bullpen as he'll stand in with a runner in scoring position at second and 1 away. Close to the bag at second there, now the pitch. 1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2.
That's right. Wait for your pitch.
Here's a swing, and he saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. On to first, and it's dropped. Luckily for him, though, there'll be no advance.
Let's take a look at that play at first here in show motion. He's close to making a great save here. You can see him try to backhand it, but it doesn't quite want to stay in the glove. May have hit him more in the palm, and he can't prevent the throwing error.
Alex Presley will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Runner not going anywhere at second. Now the pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here.
Come on, Alex.
And here's a swing and a miss, and that, folks, is a big out number two.
All right, a big strikeout there. And, you know, that keeps that tying run at second with two away now.
Brian Dozier will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance of redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. He could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Full count now, 3-2.
And I'll tell you, this is an inning that you really don't want to continue any further. So this next pitch really needs to be a strike.
The 3-2 pitch. Swing and ooh, he saws him off with that one. Grounded foul. Still two strikes. Fastball, and it's hit on the ground to short. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. One for the Twins, thanks to this swing off the bat of Jason Kubel. We're through seven this afternoon, and this is now a 2-1 ball game. Aramis Ramirez will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And when you need a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk's not on the agenda. You better bear down right here.
The pitch, and he takes a cold strike at the knees, and that'll run things full. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. And now a swing here by Ramirez as he sends this one high in the air out to deep left field. And this will find the seats in left for a home run. Solo home run there for Aramis Ramirez. And it gives the Brewers a 3-1 lead.
Maybe a big swing of the bat right there. That's going to give them that ever-important insurance run here in the top of the eighth and make this a two-run ball game. That's going to allow his bullpen to pitch with a little more freedom out there.
Your attention, please.
New pitcher coming on now as they'll hand it off to Casey Fien here. Carlos Gomez will be the first one to greet him as he'll start fresh here with the bases empty following the home run. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Bases empty here with nobody out. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Swing by Gomez and a ground ball to short. They may want to hurry. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
Yeah, just a little chopper right here, but with this guy's speed, there's nothing routine about this play. And he's able to get rid of it quickly to get his man.
Jonathan Lucroy will dig in with one in and one away. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
Yeah, when that's upstairs like that, that's a pitch you've got to leave alone and make him bring something down.
Here he comes on 2-2. Swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
Right over the top here with the four-seam fastball. Good drive through the release. Just threw it right by him at the letters.
Juan Francisco will try again. 0-for-3 thus far. Two out, nobody on. Here now the 2-2. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Brewers get one on the home run by Aramis Ramirez. On now to the bottom of inning number eight. It's now 3-1 Milwaukee. Joe Mauer will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far. 0-for-3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one. Usually a major force in their offense.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out.
Good job out there on the mound. Down in the count, 3-0 to start this inning. He comes back to retire the guy on a ground ball.
Brandon Kinstler will get the call now as he'll try to get the final two outs here and get this one on to the ninth inning. Josh Willingham will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Won't go after the 2-1 sinker, and it's three balls and a strike now.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because These guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And it's full now, 3-2.
And that's right where you want to be with your specialty pitches. If you can start them knee-high and let them dip out of the strike zone, you'll have a lot of success with locations like that one.
Three-two, here it comes. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
Yeah, he had the count in his favor, 3-1, and then got a little too over-anxious at the plate. You see, he winds up chasing two pitches out of the zone, either of which could have easily been ball four.
Oswaldo Arcia will stand in as they're quickly down to their final four outs tonight. And this is hit hard up the middle. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They still trail it here 3-1. Caleb Gindel will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth. Here's the 1-1. And this is hit well towards the hole. And there's a base hit, and this could wind up as an important insurance strike here as the leadoff man's aboard to start the ninth.
And they're keeping the pressure on, even with the two-run lead here in the ninth. They'd love to increase their lead a bit before they take it to the bottom of the ninth. That's for sure.
Scooter Gennett will try again, 0-for-3 thus far. Here's a ground ball to first. To second for one. Return throw gets him at first. It's a 3-6-1 double play.
Sharply hit here, but right at the first baseman coming off the bag. So he gets the ball rolling as they pull off the nice 3-6-1 double play.
Gene Segura will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Right side, but foul, and he'll try it again. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Brewers go down quietly, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Jim Henderson is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
29, Jim Henderson.
Jason Kubel will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. The 2-1 home. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And a dive, but he can't pull it in out in right center. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
And that's a big double right there, down by two, but more importantly, that's going to get the tying run to the plate. So we're going to see how they want to handle this defensively now with the open base.
Trevor Plouffe will step in as the possible tying run, but just a single here could make this a one-run game. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Now a fastball. Look out as he has to duck out of harm's way there. Nervous time now in that third base dugout.
Heck, nervous time up here. My heart's racing, and I'm just watching this game.
Swing and a hot shot toward third. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Sometimes when you know that you're not going to have a play, this is what you have to do. Here, no shot to throw him out down there at third, so he's just going to play it smart, take a bite out of it.
Osmil Pinto will get a chance to swing the bat here, and he'll do it in a good spot as he has runners at first and second and nobody out in the inning. Full count, 3-2.
They're definitely making him work out there. He came in trying to shut the door, and he has not had an easy time.
Swing and a hard hit ball to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. He'll come home with it. Oh, and Braun fires a great throw. He's out at home plate.
Well, he's trying to do what he can to get his guys a step closer to tying this thing, but that time, he was a little too optimistic. They tag him out easily at home plate.
Pedro Florimond will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Slider gets him swinging, two gone.
That is a big time to come up with a strikeout in a tight game like this. You've still got that tying run over there at first, but with two away now, you don't necessarily need a ground ball to get you out of this.
Alex Presley will stand in as their last chance now. For the third baseman Ramirez, and the throw is high, but he'll be called out at the bag as the first baseman came down with it in time, and the ball game is over.
Yeah, you know, this game kind of felt like it could have been played back in 1968. Very well played, very low scoring, very quick game too. I'll tell you, I could go for a few more of these this year. That'd be okay by me.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. And guys, the Brewers were given an excellent starting pitching performance from this man, Giovanni Gallardo. Don't put that card in your bicycle spokes. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, it wasn't exactly a complete game, but he did get him into the seventh inning, and that was enough to get his guys into position to win this ball game.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. find out more, head on over to theshownation.com. The Brewers win it 3-1. So long from Minneapolis.